What do you think to the former president, President Jammeh? What are your opinions on him? He's not president anymore, so you can say whatever you want.
He's ex-president. You know, me, I'm not into politics. I hate politics. I never had a voter's card. I never voted. I don't like politics at all. I hate it. But I love to listen to news. I know what is going on. I'm current, but I hate politics. Our current president, really, every human being have ups and downs. You have the good and the bad. Because him ruling the country for 22 years, you know. Really, he tried for us. Because he was the first person who gave us television. We didn't have a national television. Yeah.
German.
Yeah. He gave us our first university. You know, and girls' education free. Then, in life, don't only look at the negative. Look at the good. Then he have at least tried for us. You know. So, him, what I would say is, he's just being too greedy. Yeah. Because in life, if you want it all, you lose it all. If he ruled for 22 years, that was too much. Then he was being greedy. He didn't want to give chance to others. You know. And he, I would call him a dictator. Yeah. Because whatever comes to his mind, that is what he would do. He don't listen to people or take advice or options. So if somebody can be in power for 22 years, then you know that person must be a dictator. Because if he listen to people or he give chance to others, he could have not been there up till now. Then it means he use force. And anything force means you are dictating people. Yeah. So that was that.
Were you personally affected by anything from his regime? Anything in your life, your work, your family, anything like this?
For me, no. Because what I always say is, anybody who rules the country, let there be peace and stability. That was just my prayer. That one day he will leave. No matter what. You understand? So, but if there is peace and stability, then I'm okay with it. And because Africa, I will say this thing. Africa is Africa. You know, we have our own mentality. You know, we are all hungry. Everybody wants to come and take. Not the, even the best person will come during the campaign, say this thing, I will do this, I will do that, this, but he's there for his pocket. So that is why they don't like to leave the power. But what I always pray for is peace and stability. So if there is peace and stability, I'm okay with it. So he never affected me in any way. Yeah.
Did you hear about how he left the presidency? There was the election and yeah. He lost, but yeah. Then he tried to keep the power. You heard about
yeah,
this?
Yeah, I heard about it. At the beginning, during the campaign, he vowed and make a promise that he will never step down or they can defeat him through election. I don't know whatever he believed in before, that thing really failed him, you know. Yeah, so maybe him being so pompous, you understand, feel that, you know, nothing can bring him down. Then when he lost the election, at the beginning, to me, he was not thinking straight because he did not believe what happened. Then out of frustration, he just made that call that he accepted the defeat. He congratulated the new president that, you know, after on the 21st, he will leave the power and give this man chance and stuff like that. So after a few days, he changed his mind again and said that the elections were not fair, that there were some set of people who did not vote, that they were told that the other candidate won will win the election, so no need for them to vote. So to me, what I see is Gambians were sleeping. So now they wake up. They now know that enough is enough. And this man cannot treat us the way he was treating us like before. So he gave an order, a state of emergency, and that people will go back to the polls and vote. None of them did that. Nobody. Nobody go back to the polls and vote because they all believe that enough is enough. What they need is, there is no democracy in that country. There is dictatorship. There is brutality, police and military brutality, you understand? A lot of people were kidnapped, others were killed. So they all realize that enough is enough. We need democracy. We need somebody. You can, like what I'm doing right now, you can just say whatever you want to say and see, or say your opinion, you understand? So when he now realized that, oh, there is no way out, he have no other choice than to step down and leave for good, and which he did, and which was a very smart idea, because if not, the plan B was would have been very tough on him, you know, because they were also ready, and Gambians were ready, and ECOMOS were ready for him. Yeah, because enough was enough. Because the Gambians have already decided that he have to leave. So if they did not decide, they could have go back to the polls, you know, and still vote, do a re-election. Or some people could have stood by him. But the people who were close to him even start backing up, you know. So he had no choice than to leave for good, and which he did.
So now there's a new president, Adama Barrow.
Yeah.
Do you know much about him?
I don't know much about him, but he have been a member of a political party. You understand? If I'm not mistaken, I think he was the treasury officer or something like that in the party. So when the president arrested their leader and took him to prison, that is Usainu Dabo, then they now, among themselves, set down all the other political parties, said the only way to defeat this man is to come together. We have to do a coalition, form one single party, then we get him out of power. That is when they sit among themselves and nominate him as the presidential candidate, which I know little about him, that he was in the Gambia when he graduated. He went to UK, work as a security guard for 3 years, then come back to Gambia and invest in real estate. You know, he had money, you know, he was doing good, you know. Then from there, he was in the politics. Then they now select him as a presidential candidate. And he did pretty good because he was bold enough, you know, to stand against that man, you know, somebody who ruled a country for 22 years, you know. He had everything, you know. You being, for the first time being a candidate, you stood against him and, you know, say things, you know, and let him know that we are coming for that seat, you know. So he was really bold. He was really bold and strong and very brave too. To stand as a president candidate and win the election.
You have to be standing up against a dictator.
Yeah, he was strong.
Very courageous.
Yeah, really.
President Barrow says that, I quote, that he will reform the Gambia and free it from corruption.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that? Do you believe that? Do you think it's a thing that will happen?
Yeah. Why I don't believe that is because as I am talking to you right now, those people who form the coalition are not in good terms among themselves right now, because there is the parliamentary election, you know, the regional election, all those kind of things. So what they are trying to do is they are trying to split from that main coalition party to go back to their various parties. And now, to my own point of view, what I see is things are not okay among themselves. So they are pointing fingers at each other. Then the promises they made to us, I don't think they will fulfill it if they are behaving the way they are behaving right now. Because everybody is going back to their own party. Everybody is doing campaign. Everybody's, you know, trying to defend his own party so that the party will not die. Then if they all go back to their various parties, how can they fulfill their promise to us? Then to me, I don't believe that. I believe it was just false, empty promises. Yeah, because they are all the same. Because the people he is with, they are old school parties. And like, if you look at the new government, all of them are old people. There are no youths in them, which is not fair. They have to give the youths chance, not take people like, there is a minister who was in the first regime and he's still in the government. That's not fair. The man is old. The owner of the party that they took to prison, that he stood as a candidate, it's old. He could have given chance to others and the youths. Yeah, they said they are our elders. They could have fought for us and let us take over, because they are gone. They are ages. You know, they are all in their 80s, 90s. So they cannot do anything for us. Yeah, it's empty promises. They are there for themselves. And if they separate, everybody go back to their own party, then what are we talking about? Yeah. It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, that's true. But imagine if that wasn't false promises.
Yeah.
And that corruption went down a lot in the Gambia.
Yeah.
Life became a little bit better.
Yeah.
Would you personally think about going back to the Gambia and starting a life there again?
Yeah, me, I never have problem of going back to the Gambia. Since the other regime and this regime, I never have a problem of going back. Because what I believe is, if there is peace and stability in my country, I can do whatever I want to do because I'm a citizen of that country. So it's not because of their promise that would make me go back. No, I'm going back because I'm a citizen and I have the right to be there. And anything I have outside, I'll still bring it back to my country and invest in my country because that's my country. So it's not about the new regime or the ex-regime. I still have that belief that they are all the same. Yeah.
So it makes no difference.
It makes no difference. They are all the same. Yeah. That's
an interesting answer. Did you hear about Morocco is part of the African Union again now?
Yes, I heard about after 33 years, the king now accept to go back to the African Union. Yeah. And which after the African Union summit in Addis Ababa, he made a travel to several African countries, you know, to tie some relations, bilateral relationships and some investment and stuff like that, which was a very good idea and which I really love. Yeah, I like it. When I heard the news that he's back to African Union, I really love it because Morocco, as I used to say, is the gateway between Africa and Europe. So if they are back to Africa, it's advantage for all of us, all the Africans, because it will make it easier for us. The travel, you know, the business, everything now. If I make it here, I can easily do my business from Morocco to my country because I know the country and it's part of African Union. So it's a big advantage for us Africans and we really love it. And they will stop, the Moroccans will stop calling us Africans. Yeah, because they have that mentality. he will tell you Africa, Africa. Yeah. So if they are in Africa, I don't think they will call us that names again, because maybe because they were not in the African Union, that is why they call us Africans. So I really love it. I like it too, that he's back. And he made a very, very wise, take a very good step of going back to the African Union.
Yeah, I think so too. Do you think this will have an effect on migration between West Africa, Morocco, and also with Europe?
No, I don't think so. It makes no difference. Because I think Libya is part of the African Union. And more people are entering in Libya than Morocco. Because Libya, you see, like a boat can take 500 or 600 migrants at a time. And they are in the African Union. So to me, it makes no difference. It will just tighten and smoothen the relation between Africa to Africa. Yeah.
Is there anything else you would like to say on this?
About my country or Morocco?
Anything you want. Anything. This is the last question.
So. Okay. What I want to say is my country is the new government should try and be together, you know, and stop pointing fingers, because they are blaming each other, which is not the promise they made to the people, you know. So they should try and fulfill their promise, bring real democracy in that country, you know, help us out to boom the economy so that the youths that are leaving our country to go, you understand, because we have a lot of youths who die in Libya, especially the Gambians, you know, a lot of them take that journey to Libya. There are few Gambians here, though the majority always go through Libya, and a lot lost their life there. So if this new government can change things, create jobs, you know, infrastructure, you know, I believe a lot of youths will not leave the country and give us peace and stability and democracy. But that is what they promise us. But if they start pointing fingers out and just trying to part, then I don't think they will fulfill their promise to us. Yeah, that is that.
This is the most transparent, rig-proof elections in the whole world. I'm calling you to wish you all the best. The Gambian people have spoken, and I have no reason to contest the will of the Almighty Allah. Hey. Hello? Are you hearing me?